final year PG from Gandhi Medical College, and my topic for today is violence against doctors, a never-ending problem, under the guidance of Dr. T. Krupal Singh sir, Professor and HOD of Gandhi Medical College. As we all know, violence against doctors is a global phenomenon, and violence also includes the damage and the loss of property according to the Clinical Establishment Act 1890. And the most common causes is the patient dissatisfaction and agitated friends and relatives accompanying the patients. And the most common places of attack are at the emergency and the casualty, ICU, and the post-operative surgical wards. The objectives are to study the scenario of the violence and to study the case details and to list the precautionary measures taken by the resident doctors against the violence. And this is a cross-sectional study which has been done in Gandhi Hospital, Secunderabad, which is during a one-month duration, including the resident doctors in all the departments who have faced violence at least once in the last 1 year. The study included 86 resident doctors. It was given in a questionnaire form, and they were interviewed regarding the scenario of the violence and the case details. And the data was entered in the MS Excel sheet and was analyzed. First, the thing, medicine department was have faced more violence compared to other departments, and including we, the forensic fraternity also experienced the violence, which is around 8%. And pathology being the least, it is around 2.3%. The male resident doctors have experienced more violence compared to the female resident doctors, and the 37% has experienced at least more than 5 times during the past 1 year, and the verbal attack being the most common than the physical attack. And the security was available, but yet the violence has occurred. The CCTV was present in 54% of the cases, but it was not monitored. And the emergency and the casualty is the most common place, like around 75% the violence has occurred. And in the mortuary, about 8% violence has occurred. And during the late hours in the evening, around 68% of the violence has occurred. And the residents have taken help from the other colleagues to handle the situation during this violence. Around it's like 27.9%, and they tried to explain the situation in detail and calmly. And the cases which increase the violence is like the patients who are around above 60 years. And the patients who entered the hospital were like 43% in a critical ill condition. And more than half of the cases, like around 50%, were referred to our hospital from other private hospitals. And in 34% cases where the VIPs and the political pressure was more on the doctors. And in almost all the cases, the condition, the diagnosis and the treatment were explained in detail. But in some cases, like around 14%, the high-risk consent was missed. And in most of the cases, like 70%, 5 or more attenders were accompanying the patient. And the precautionary measures taken by the residents, the most common are the limiting the number of the attenders along with the patient. And the conclusion, the resident doctors of different departments have faced the violence irrespective of the security availability and the CCTV surveillance. Emergency and casualty and the inpatient departments were the common places where the violence has occurred. And the evening time, that is like the late hours, that was the time that the violence has occurred. And age above 60 years and a critically ill patient and reference from the other hospitals with the most common details of the cases involved in violence. And the most common precautionary measure was to limit the attenders accompanying the patient. According to the Government Gazette Ordinance No. 16 of 2007, anyone who destroys the hospital property or anyone who attacks any hospital personnel or anyone who interferes with the duties of the hospital staff are liable to punishment for 3 years jail, imprisonment, and penalty up to 50,000. The recommendations are the security in the emergency casualty and the inpatient department should be alert when a mob is coming along with the patient at the entry, and the CCTV surveillance should be available at the required places, and the strengthening of the administrative systems of the respective medical colleges and hospitals help us deal with the situation in a better way, and adequate and the timely availability of the security staff in a case where the help is required, and limiting the number of the attenders accompanying the patient should be done, and the strict adherence to timely visits of the attenders into the hospital wards. And the concern should be explained in detail to the patient as well as the patient attenders in their own language, and high-risk concern should be taken and also well explained in the critically ill and the terminally ill, injured and preoperative patients in both oral and written formats. And the best way to avoid the violence against doctor is to have proper communication as well as documentation.